Oh, good morning. Feels like this has been more than a week. It feels like it's been forever. Hi, how you doing? Tis I again. Tis Nicola. I'm going to sing you a few songs today. Once I've got a few people tuned in, I'm going to talk to you about a really simple way to write a song. Like really easy shortcut ways to if you don't play an instrument, to access an instrument. Because most people, and I say most because not all, have got a smartphone. As long as you've got a smartphone, whether it's Android or whether it's an iPhone, you can access something that will help you. What am I trying to say? You can access something to help you make music. But anyone that tunes into here can obviously access Facebook, so we'll obviously have a PC as well. So that, again, I can give you ways to access music, to write songs. So we'll talk about lyric writing. I'll play you a couple of songs first, though. And probably songs you've heard, and I apologise because I should be writing this down. I forget that, because ordinarily I don't play to the same crowds, so I can recycle songs. So this is proven a little different to that. So I'm going to do... do Dakota because I love it. If that's okay. Hello. Right. Thinking back, thinking of you. Summertime, think it was June. client-wise. Cool. All right, so songwriting is really, really easy. And I know I keep saying it, and it's easy for me to say because I can play a guitar, and I have done for several years, and I've also written songs for several years. So it's easy for me to go, songwriting's really easy. But what I have learned in my experience of songwriting and tutoring in songwriting is how to make it simple. Because when you sit down to write a song, first of all, there's this overwhelming sense that how on earth am I going to write music? I don't know music and I don't know what to put together. And, you know, it must be so complicated. And if you do know a little bit of music, you're like, but there's thousands of chords. How do I know which ones to use? And but there are some tools that really, really simplify that. And then when it comes to lyrics, you're constantly thinking, oh, no, is it? It's not going to be as smart as that person's song, or it's not going to be as good, or it's not going to flow as well. And firstly, who cares? Secondly, you've got to start writing to get past those barriers. So the first few songs I wrote, I don't mind telling you, they were awful. And I knew they were awful at the time. But you've got to start that process to then be able to reflect and go, oh, okay, I can do that better, because now I've got more of a sense of the writing, and I can use different words to say that thing there that I was trying to say. But it's going to come out. It's going to come out in its simplest form because you're inexperienced, and that's okay. There's an important thing that I say to all my students when I'm teaching them anything, but certainly about performance and things like that, is accept that you're not going to be very good straight away. Accept that you're not going to like it. Accept that it's going to go wrong. And accept that there'll be bad experience. As soon as you can do that, you can work through that. Okay? So everyone's first performance, unless you're like, you know, superhuman, involves a lot of muck-ups and a lot of feeling very embarrassed and very nervous, very trembly. But it will never be as bad as the first time. So there. So cool, right. So the first thing I'm going to tell you is that there are apps, and you can get these on your laptops, you can get them on your phones. One is called GarageBand. You can get that for your iPhone, which is normally already on there when you get an iPhone. And the other one for Android is called Band Labs. Okay, so they look slightly different, but they have the same tools on there. So Band Lab's slightly different in the sense of, because it's Android, you have to navigate it slightly differently. I'm going to talk about GarageBand first. So basically, and both programs do this, if you go into GarageBand and create a new track, there is actually a section of loops that you can use to write your song. Not only that, if you choose to play a guitar or a keyboard from the front menu and you pick smart guitar or smart piano, it will give you piano chords and guitar chords right in front of you. You don't actually have to know about keys or how to play. You can just strum the guitar with your finger, or you can push a piano note, because it's difficult to explain without showing you, but you just push one of the white keys on the chord and it'll give you a chord up the piano. If you've got an iPhone, have a look at GarageBand. Take your time with it, because before you're familiar with it, it can seem quite frustrating to navigate your way around, okay? But I have a short video, actually, and what I might do is I might make it accessible. I'll pop it on YouTube on a private link and post it to the page, and it will show you just how to get started with GarageBand and Band Labs. But if not, as I keep saying, go online to YouTube and just find a backing track or instrumental. And then the way you start to write your lyrics is to organise your words. If you're not a natural poet, for example, if everything you write doesn't come out rhyming, it doesn't mean you can't. Okay, so what I like to do is I like to get what I call my bank of words. Okay, so what I'll do is, whatever I'm feeling at the time, whatever I think I'm going to be writing about, I'll choose that subject, and I will write, without pause or hesitation, every single word that comes into my head. Now, when I say without pause or hesitation, I mean don't apply that filter. Don't apply that filter that says, hang on a minute, that's not related in the slightest to this subject. Doesn't matter, write it down. There's a reason your brain is throwing that at you, okay? And just write down every single word. Or get your phone open onto a voice note and just say every single word that comes into your head. Remove the filter, just get as many words out as you possibly can, okay? Because that's going to be your word bank. So when you come to actually writing, you've got a collection of words that already relate to A, the topic you're talking about, but B, more importantly, how you feel about the topic you're talking about because they've come out of your head. And then you use that to start building your verses and your choruses, or if you want to use it for poetry, to start building your rhymes. Because then each word from that, you expand on again. Or you choose a word and you write every word you can think of that rhymes under that word. And again, doesn't have to make any sense whatsoever. You choose the ones that are relevant and in context, and hey presto, you'll have one. Next week I might give you a bit of a demonstration of that, okay? And because I haven't prepared myself with the tools for it, but I have a flip chart. So I'll set that up and I will show you exactly what I mean and just how easy it is to get yourself a collection of words to start from. And if you start with a poem, you can then transfer that over to a song. So the way I look at things and how words and our messages in words happen, I'll go from a story, so I'll use this. It's quite a big portion of words. We'll use loads of joining words. There'll be lots of descriptive words, but it'll be long. And, you know, you want to get as much description in there as possible. And, you know, you've got lots of paragraph to fill up with that. And to, you know, to take somebody on your journey through your story, you've got beginning, middle, end. And you've got a lot of room to do that. So your story is here. When you're writing a poem, you are giving them those messages in short. So what you're doing is you're losing some of the information that's doubled up. You're losing some of the information that that is too wordy, and you're reducing it to a poem. So you're reducing your message to this so that it's an easy read and easy to digest, and you don't have to work too hard for it because it's all lovely and set out in a nice form that rhymes, it's pleasant, it's short. And then when you get to a song, it's an even simpler format. So, and what you're doing is you're putting it into a melody so that it's even easier to digest, because you're adding music to the feeling. So half of what you're doing is already giving someone the emotion and the message before you even say any words. So you can choose your words carefully and you can really simplify it. So for example, if I start a song like that, you already know there's a good chance it's going to be quite chipper. I was walking down the street, looking for folks to meet, taking my time just to look at you through a window on the broom. I don't know, whatever. Don't know where I was going with that. Okay, so you've got quite a chipper song there. You already know it. So that's half the work done. So the lyrics don't really have to be that, you know, there's not that much pressure on the lyrics, okay? So, and again, if I do this. You know it's going to be quite sad. Sad and reflective, yeah? So I've already given you half the emotion. So you can reduce that even more, okay? So, story, poem, song. That's what makes it easier, because you don't have to put that much in. Let's sing another song for you, because I'm rattling on. But if you're interested, please come along next Monday and I'll give you a session on that. It is very easy once you remove all the unknown. Once you remove the sea of possibilities and just go, do you know, just make it simple for yourself. Use two chords and use your word bank, write a song, done. Let's have a look. So, one of the songs that I realised I haven't played in a while was a George Ezra song, which I really, really like. So,
my house in Budapest, my hidden treasure chest, golden grand piano, my beautiful Castillo, you. All the land that I've achieved, it may be hard for you to stop and believe, but for you, ooh, you, ooh, I'd leave it all. Yeah, for you, ooh, you, ooh, I'd leave it all. Give me one good reason why I should never make a change. say the word, I'll up and run over to you. Ooh, you, ooh, I'd give it all. Yeah, for you. Ooh, you, ooh, I'd give it all. Give me one good reason why I should never make a change. So much if you take my hand, but for you, ooh, you, ooh, I'd leave it all. Yeah, for you, ooh, you, ooh, I'd leave it all. Give me one good reason why I should never make a change. My hidden treasure chest, gold and grand piano, my beautiful Castillo, you, ooh, you, ooh, I'd leave it all. Yeah, for you, ooh, you, ooh, I'd leave it all.
Alright, cool. Let's have a look. Okay, so 10 more minutes, let's still have a couple of songs. What can we do? So feel free, if you want to request, if it's something I know, I can play it, but I do have a very small repertoire because I'm lazy. And I'm ashamed to admit it, but I make no effort to change it, unfortunately. What can you say? I'm quite liking this one as well at the moment, a little bit of a Alanis Morissette.
Won the lottery and died the next day. It's a black fly in your Chardonnay. It's a death row pardon 2 minutes too late. And isn't it ironic, don't you think? It's like a rain free to fly compared to suitcase. Kissed his kids goodbye. He waited his whole damn life to take that flight. And as the plane crashed down, he thought, well, isn't this nice? Isn't it ironic? Don't you think? It's like rain. On your way and think. It's like 10,000 spoons when all you need is a knife. It's me, the man of your dreams, meeting his beautiful wife. And isn't it ironic, don't you think? A little too ironic, I really do think.
Try a song I haven't done for a while, actually. I've tried it a couple of weeks ago with some friends and it went terribly, but I'm gonna try it with you guys. So be warned, this could go really badly. Very sorry. I forgot that. I need to revisit that. I thought I knew it a lot better than that. I sung that so many times in my lifetime. You'll believe. One more song, okay? Let's have a look. A bit of a bouncy one.
Sometimes I feel I've got to run away. I've got to get away from the pain you drive into the heart of me, the love we share. seems to go nowhere. And I lost my light, for I toss and turn, I can't sleep at night. Once I ran to you, now I run from you. This tainted love you've given, I'll give you all the girl could give you. I'll take my tears, yeah, that's not nearly all. Oh, tainted love, tainted love. Now I know I've got to run away. I've got to get away. You don't really want any more from me to make things right. You need someone to hold you tight, and you think love is to pray. Well, I'm sorry, I don't pray that way. Once I ran.
Okay, that's it, I'm done. So if any of you are watching this back, and for those that are watching now, next Monday, bring pen and paper, a lot of paper, because we're going to do a lot of, if you don't have any issues with reading and writing, writing in particularly, although even if you do, as long as you can put down your interpretation of the words that you're trying to write, that's okay. There's no expectations on it, as long as you can understand what you're writing. So pen, paper, and a willingness to go nuts at trying to write a song. And I will sit and do that next Monday to try and get you guys writing. Yeah, we're going to start in a poetry kind of way, though, so. Cool. You're very, very welcome. I will see you next Monday. Thank you for having me, as always. And take care. Stay safe. Have a good week. Bye-bye.